মালয়েশিয়ার প্রধানমন্ত্রীর সাথে বৈঠক শেষে কথা বলছেন অন্তর্বর্তী সরকারের প্রধান উপদেষ্টা ডক্টর ইউনূস, সরাসরি যাচ্ছি তার বক্তব্যে।
Particularly the youth have made remarkable sacrifice in their quest for freedom and discrimination-free new Bangladesh. The interim government has been entrusted with the formidable task of building an inclusive and just Bangladesh to fulfill the aspirations of the mass people. We deeply appreciate the unwavering support and cooperation of our brotherly country Malaysia at this historic moment. Bilateral relations flourish through shared values, trust and appreciation of mutual interests. We renewed our commitment to take bilateral relations to a new height. We broadly had discussed three core areas of cooperation: political, trade and investment, cultural and humanitarian. We discussed the issue of safe repatriation of the forcibly displaced Myanmar nationals to Myanmar. We requested the Prime Minister to persuade Rohingya repatriation issue in ASEAN fora so that this protracted crisis is resolved at the soonest. We acknowledge the importance of regular bilateral consultation at foreign advisor, foreign minister level, foreign secretary general level, and other working levels. Excuse me. We look forward to the fourth joint commission meeting to be held in Dhaka in early next year. To boost the two-way trade, it is imperative to resume the trade negotiation committee meeting to conclude free trade agreement between the two countries. We also discussed to explore the possibility of signing new...
For decades, I suppose, as a person who have taken that initiative, your lack of experience in governance, as they say, is nothing as compared to your strength, there is passion for the poor, marginalized, and for the people. And I think that is what we lack in this world today. You look at the situation in Gaza, now in the Lebanon, what's lacking is deficit in humanity, in justice, in compassion. So thank you very much. I just feel like giving a lecture on Rabindranath Tagore, but that's not the occasion. But I took this initiative early enough to give you a call and give my support as a friend and as a nation that is friendly to Bangladesh, notwithstanding some controversies, some criticism. I do recognize that the fast progress that we have achieved, the economic success, and now the last year also we have seen this phenomenal growth and massive investments, Malaysia becoming the hub of semiconductor in the region, and becoming an attractive destination for investments in terms of data center and artificial intelligence. But can we deny, therefore, the role of Malaysian professionals, and to an extent, the role of many Bangladeshi workers? Now, that's why when you appeal for us to consider the issue of 7,000 or more who were duly registered, but then lost that opportunity because of the political development and uprising here, I will certainly give that a major consideration. At least the first phase, subject to all the conditions being met, can be taken as soon as possible.
18,000.
Yeah, 18,000, but the first phase, once we satisfy, I think we'll do it at the fast track, fast phase.
Thank you.
This is very quiet. And the other issues on investments, of course, we have Malaysian companies here and Bangladeshi companies in Malaysia. I think what we need to do, if we want this sort of comprehensive strategic partnership, then we should give some attention and preference to these companies, we in Malaysia, to the investments from Bangladesh, and you here too, to make sure that any teething problems be given a fast attention in a transparent manner. I share your vision. In Malaysia and my team, we assume our focus is governance, anti-corruption, and economic fundamentals. We do not compromise with this, because we don't need to associate political elite and political leaders assuming office to amass wealth and enrich themselves or their families or their cronies. And therefore, I empathize, I understand fully well that though we want Malaysian companies that have been operating here to be given adequate consideration, I will not compromise the issue of transparency and the proper due diligence in the process. And then, of course, higher education, research in all fields, we should look at it and explore and collaborate, and we can fast-track. The Minister of Foreign Affairs is here, Minister Michi is here, in terms of the negotiations, whatever form that you want, in terms of trade arrangements. But what is important is having the Joint Commission meeting as soon as possible. You suggest probably early next year. I see even if they are ready, they should come earlier. I'm not imposing on them too fast. Then, on the ASEAN sectoral dialogue partner, where in the past there were encumbrances, not created by us, but some members, because we have to achieve only through consensus. But let me assure you that I will give this some priority. The foreign ministry officials will start connecting with their counterpart, and probably once things seem to be quite settled, then bring up to the attention the foreign minister. If it need be, I will personally interfere and speak to my counterpart. The fortunate thing in the region, ASEAN is, you know, the most peaceful region in the world. Fastest growth in terms of the economy. And our relationship with our neighbors is excellent. And that is to me important in terms of propelling and giving importance to the economy. And so there are concerns you express, and I am satisfied with your assurance, because Malaysia is a multiracial, multi-religious country. We realize that to succeed, we have to be, to recognize the importance of the majority Muslims, and to also respect the rights of those